tell you the really important thing. That it was written to honor people that died on 9/11, just like the people that died. It was written so we would remember them, not forget them. And all the people. It was written to honor the men and women here on the home front that look back towards day in and day out that we all take for granted. The police officers and the sheriffs and the deputies and the firemen. They do it because they love the community and they love to serve the people. They do it because they're service oriented, folks. They don't get paid enough, just like our school teachers don't. I did that for a while. But we should notice them out there occasionally and walk up and give them a handshake and tell them how much you appreciate it because they do a hell of a job. And if they were gone for one day, I promise you, you'd recognize them then. Last but not least, it was written to say thank you and to honor the men and women of the United States military that will take the fight overseas in the other country so that we don't have to deal with it on our beautiful home front. Those men and women are just like we are. They don't want people over here on our soil in the United States shooting and carrying on and, you know, killing our children. They ask them why they do what they do, and they said, so my kids don't have to do it. So about 3 years ago, even though I've always been a patriot, I grew up in a military family. That's why I would travel overseas and all the stuff we didn't come natural to us. But I just thought I was committed to the military until my daughter was born. Because if you're doing it so your kids don't have to do it, you're also doing it so my kids don't have to do it. And God bless you for that. So here's the story I wanted to tell you guys. I'm not a big stingy, but I had to stop along the roar on the shore route today and wipe some tears out of my eyes. But it brought back some memories. When we pulled into Nashville one morning about 3:30 a.m., and I got off the bus because I woke up and I couldn't sleep, and I went back to my house and got into bed. And I had this old redneck roommate, and we just lived in this. Not too many shacks are still left inside the city limits of Nashville, but we had one of them. And I got up about 7:30, 8 o'clock, maybe it's a little bit later. Went downstairs and hit the button on the machine, and I just heard all these crazy messages about, you know, what's going on, and blah, blah, blah. So I ran upstairs, woke him up. We only had one TV in the house. It's in his bedroom. Good over, man. I got to watch and see what's going on. We was looking at the TV, and we saw what had happened. There and watched the second plane hit. Man, I didn't even grab my clothes. I jumped in my car and I headed home to my folks. I headed to my family as fast as I could go because who knows, you know, I didn't know what was coming next. But the point I was going to make is by the time I got on the road, and I just drive back roads all the way to where I live from Nashville, Tennessee, because I live in the middle of nowhere still. I mean, we're 70 miles from the nearest interstate, 70 miles from the nearest mall. We've got the big river and the big lake, and I love it! See, it's a big deal. I send my wife off shopping. She can go spend the whole day going to the mall, and I'm sitting home. So I'm driving along these old country roads, and nobody's known about this for more than an hour and a half. And it looked like the route we were driving on today. There was American flags everywhere I looked. Red, white, and blue, everywhere I looked. What a shame these people. I know every house on that road that flies the American flag on a normal day. And I said, what a shame these people don't fly these flags every day. Well, guess what? 2 or 3 weeks later, I drove that same stretch of road, just the flags that were normally there. Not all this stuff along the way. And I thought, man, how quickly we forget it. And you know, and put our flags back in the closet. I got to see some American pride here today, and it filled my heart with joy, man. You guys were awesome. I'm telling you, I would give $1 million if I could have had my little girl and my wife on that motorcycle so they could have seen this, because y'all got something special going on up here. Don't stop doing it. God bless you. across the USA.